Alright, what's going on YouTube? My name is Brady Nunez. As you guys can see, I'm active duty in the Air Force. And last week, I was in the Dominican Republic for a video shoot. And before I went, I was wondering basically what the title of this video is. I was wondering to myself, is the Dominican Republic safe to go travel in? Yo, what's going on YouTube? So if you guys watched my last video, you guys will see that I just landed in Dominican Republic. It's been a day since then. And it's our first day off of the resort. We're gonna go on a little excursion. We're gonna get on a boat.
Hey, you know I'm so fly like Aladdin. Man, I spit fire like a dragon. Yeah, my girl so fine.
Alrighty, guys. So it's taken me quite a while to get this video out to you guys. I want to say approximately 2 weeks since I've been back from the Dominican Republic, but for good reason. One, obviously, I wanted to crank out that edit for Viva More Travel.
What's going on, guys? My name is Ryan Harrison, owner of Viva More Travel. We're out here in beautiful Punta Cana, checking out a few of our properties.
Based on our own travel experiences, we provide you an insight unmatched by any.
And two, I've actually started contracting as a wedding videographer. I actually filmed a wedding 2 days ago. So a lot's been on my plate. I'm also still active duty. But yeah, that's kind of what's been on my plate lately in my life. I typically don't like to spread myself too thin with the things that I'm doing just because it's easy to neglect certain aspects, and the quality of what you put out will decrease if you try to rush things out. So yeah, that's what's been going on in my life. So yeah, the topic of today's video obviously is, how was the Dominican Republic? Was it safe to travel in? Because before I left, I was actually looking up a lot of videos and I did some Google searches, and it was very vague, right? There's actually like no videos out right now on the current situation, because a couple months ago and like last year, you hear a lot of things, a lot of bodies were turning up, you know, a lot of tourists, things going bad on resorts. And the first thing I do wanna say when it comes to the Dominican Republic is the water is not drinkable, okay? But a very positive on the resort that we were staying on is you could literally get a bottle of water anywhere. So like typically when you go to a bar and you ask for water, they're just gonna pour you like a little courtesy cup, you know, and fill that up. But at any of the bars at the resort, if you ask for water, they give you a full like 16 ounce water bottle. Yeah, they hook it up in that regard, which is nice. So that's number one. Number two, if you do plan on leaving the resort and partaking in the nightlife, drinking alcohol, definitely keep your eyes and ears open. Maintain a visual on the alcoholic beverage, who's pouring it, who's providing it for you. I have personal experience with these sort of things, so just something to be aware of. But other than that, our experience was extremely positive. So the reason that I'm making this video is kind of just bring awareness that these things were happening in the Dominican Republic and in Cancun in Mexico. And that was kind of the purpose of me and Ryan's trip. As a travel agent, we're kind of trying to show people that these places actually are safe to go to. When you hear things like this in the news, it's gonna scare a lot of people away. But I want to be here to tell you guys that everything was good on our end. And I just want to say that no matter where you go, you're gonna hear things in the news. Like, I'm from Maryland. 30 minutes north of me is a city called Baltimore. You guys may have heard of Baltimore. And it's funny because I spent a lot of time in Baltimore, but it may be like the third or fourth most dangerous city in the United States. But it's funny because I go there all the time and I don't worry about anything, you know? So it's the same thing. Like, people could be apprehensive about traveling to Maryland, and if they're going to be spending time in Baltimore, they might be super nervous about going just because of all the things you hear in the news. But I just feel like no matter where you go, if you're in the United States, if you're in the UK, If you're going to South America, just do your research, you know. Just know which areas are safe, do your research beforehand, and move accordingly, you know what I mean? There's spots in Baltimore that I know not to set foot in for those exact reasons, you know. Go about your business, have a plan, know what you're going to do, and you're going to be fine no matter where you travel. Obviously, the risk is always there, but you got to live your life. You know what I'm saying? Don't be so afraid of traveling. Just make sure that you keep your eyes and ears open. Obviously, you're away from home. No matter where you travel, be sure to kind of take a look at the laws, because things are different. You know, the customs and courtesies in different countries and even states may be a little bit different than where you live. Okay, don't assume that just because you go about your business a certain way where you live, that it's gonna be like that everywhere else. That's kind of like the topic of this video. It is titled, "Is the Dominican Republic Safe to Travel To?" So to answer that question, yes, absolutely it is. But obviously, if you're traveling correctly, if you do your research, those are my tips for you guys. Get out there, experience the world, because I'm gonna continue to do so. If you guys are subscribed to this channel, you guys are gonna see all my future travel. I love to film travel videos. It's one of my favorite types of videos to film. So for my current subscribers, the people who watch my videos on a continuous basis, comment down below what type of videos you guys want me to see, because there's a lot going on with me right now. I'm the most busy that I've ever been, but this is like the most happy that I've been, because one, I'm making a good amount of money, which is always a plus. Two, there's that outlet to be creative, not only with YouTube, but in this video and photo space. I'm very happy that I'm breaking into weddings as well. And three is just going hand in hand with those weddings. The people that I'm working with now, I'm collaborating with a lot of other creatives as well. And it's awesome, guys. So yeah, leave a thumbs up. Wish me luck in my future endeavors, as I wish you luck as well. Love you guys. Thank you guys for sticking with me. Leave a thumbs up on this video, and I'll see you in the next one. Peace.